So in this tutorial, we're going to look at the general shapes of some graphs, okay? The common ones you might see. Not the trigonometric ones, we'll deal with those in a separate tutorial. So let's take them one by one, or in pairs actually. You just need to know these. We're not going to do any questions on them, we're just going to look at them. You should know the line y equals x. There it is. It sort of goes up 45 degrees from left to right. And y equals minus x, well, that goes down at 45 degrees from left to right, and it is, in fact, a reflection in the x-axis, if you remember your transformations. You might also need to think about a line which doesn't quite look like that, which is y equals mx plus c, okay, where it doesn't go through the origin because it goes through c on this axis, on the vertical axis there, and has a gradient of m. Okay, so y equals x is a very specific one. This shape here I hope you recognize as a parabola. Okay, I'm going to write that word in, although you don't really need to know it. That's the shape you get when you have a quadratic graph. If the number in front of the x is positive, in this case it's 1, you get a parabola that way up. And if the number in front of the x is negative, you get a parabola the other way up. I like to think of them as positive parabolas are happy and therefore smiling, and negative parabolas are sad and therefore, well, what's the opposite of smiling? Downward smiling. Right, now what about x cubed? There's your standard x cubed graph and its equivalent negative there. Okay, again, a reflection in the x-axis. You ought to know, because you'll have to plot these occasionally, that an x cubed graph actually might look a little bit more like that. So there's the general x cubed graph. And then we come to the reciprocal graphs. Okay, so we're going to call these ones reciprocal. Why reciprocal graphs? Because 1 over x is the reciprocal of x. That's how it's defined. And you should probably know that these lines here, so that's the x-axis and the y-axis, the curve never actually touches, and so just tends towards, gets closer and closer if you like, and so we have a fancy name for those. The x and y axes are asymptotes. Okay, that is a word that you may need to know. Okay, so we can say are asymptotes. That's how you spell it. They are lines towards which the curve tends but doesn't reach. And there's another asymptote in the next graph. The x-axis is an asymptote here, okay, and this graph, though, is the exponential graph, okay? Exponential growth gets faster and faster and faster. It never gets vertical there. You might like to think where this point here is, k to the 0, if x is 0, k to the 0 is always 1, and on both these graphs, it's 1. So this one is exponential growth. And the other one, you won't be surprised to hear, is exponential decay. Okay, and again, in exponential decay, it's particularly starting for at x equals 0 there, it gets smaller and smaller and smaller, but never reaches 0. Okay, what you need to do is you need to go away and do lots of questions on those, but you really also need to know the shapes of these graphs.